Jennifer Dunlap says, in my mid-30s while nursing my toddler, she says, this is not a rush. I'll see what I can do, Jen. Jennifer says, in my mid-30s while nursing my toddler, I have not got back the energy I had while nursing previous children, and my muscles feel fatigued much of the time in spite of sufficient protein, calories, multivitamin, collagen, CoQ10. After listening to the creatine podcast, I began supplementing 5 grams per day. This has lessened the feeling of fatigue so that I can enjoy working out again. It also apparently caused immediate ovulation symptoms after 18 months of nursing amenorrhea. There's virtually no research on creatine while nursing, which is why I chose a maintenance rather than loading dose. The toddler is 25 pounds and healthy. So your question is it safe to take the creatine while nursing? If it is, reply in there. Okay, here's what I think. So, number one, this sounds fantastic. So Jen, is the ovulation a problem because you're trying to use the nursing as birth control, or is the ovulation a sign to you that you're improving your health? Given the, let's see, would you say here? No, nursing amenorrhea. So I guess that's kind of a, 18 months is plenty of amenorrhea. Okay. There's bound to be some people who are like, damn, I wanted automatic birth control. So my impression here is if you felt fatigued and you took the creatine and all of a sudden that started reversing, then you either felt fatigued because you had low creatine synthesis or you felt fatigued because you had a methylation problem. And those aren't mutually exclusive. If you're not methylating well, the most sensitive thing that will happen is you'll synthesize less creatine. But I mean, it could have gone beyond creatine. Like it could have been that you're synthesizing less creatine and you're not regulating your dopamine properly and things like that. But certainly you're addressing a methylation issue / a creatine deficiency issue. I don't know the exact cause and effect scenario that would lead to ovulation, but it makes sense that you ovulate. Think about the regulation of fertility. The whole thought process of the body's regulation of fertility, all of it comes down to energy. It comes down to the fact that when you get pregnant, you're investing, I don't remember what the numbers are off the top of my head, something like 50,000 kilocalories in a pregnancy. And then in lactation, you're investing another, I think, 1,000 kilocalories a day or something like that. And so the whole hypothalamic regulation of sex hormones and thyroid hormone is all regulated by leptin and insulin as signals of long-term and short-term energy status. And at the cellular level, so insulin and leptin are hormones. Endocrine hormones are between tissues. But what happens at the cellular level is I think it's very plausible that something that's happening at the cellular level and the recognition of what those hormones mean to communicate that energy is present, sufficient for fertility, is going to be ATP dependent. And if you're missing creatine, then you're going to have a drop in the power of the ATP signal and the recycling of the ATP. This is the basis for why creatine is used for muscular power, but it's also the basis for why creatine is used to use energy in producing stomach acid or to communicate or to transmit light and dark signals through your eye to your brain to make vision. All over the place, creatine is super important to the cellular utilization of energy. So my guess is it's correcting a response inside the cell to the leptin and insulin. And, you know, probably I mean, 18 months is like maybe your body just decided, well, I'm done with it. or maybe your nursing frequency was declining at that point. And it was just a balance, right? Where what nursing is saying is, I just got done spending all that energy and I need time to recover that energy. And so it's a balance, right? Your body's kind of playing it like, well, the last time I invested 100,000 kilocalorie net investment was 6 months ago, and my body fat is X percent and my calories and carbs coming in are Y. And if I make this equation, what's the likelihood that if I get pregnant now, I'm going to have enough energy to do this again, right? And so the distance from pregnancy judged by the suckling response is going to be part of that equation, but so is the leptin and insulin, and so is the intracellular response to the leptin and insulin. I think what the creatine is doing is fixing the intracellular response. In terms of safety in breastfeeding, I don't think there's any evidence one way or another. It's probably safe because you could get this from meat, and there's no evidence of harm. But if you wanted to be hyper careful, I'm not saying you need to do this, but if you wanted to be like super, super careful, what I would do is divide the 5 grams over 3 or 4 meals evenly on the basis that there are very, very trace amounts of byproducts of high dose creatine. I mean, like a 5 grams. Like 5 grams will cause extraordinarily tiny amounts of toxins that appear in the urine. I mean, not toxins at the level that we're talking about, but I doubt it's a risk. But if you wanted to be hyper careful, divide the dose up evenly. All right. Thank you, Jennifer, for your question. She follows up. I nearly weaned a couple of months ago, not ovulated, and then went back to nursing heavily and started creatine and then ovulated. Yeah. So, I mean, the going back and forth is going to play a role in that as well. I don't know all the details of how it works, but you know, when you go off, there's something about the imprinting of the off response that feeds into the mathematical calculation that your cells are doing, I would guess. But yeah, the creatine, I mean, you went back and you added the creatine. So it does, I suspect that weaning down played a role in potentiating the response of the creatine, but clearly going back to the breastfeeding and adding the creatine, clearly the creatine is doing something there, because otherwise, if it was just a weaning, you would have started back when you weaned. So